that mountain peak behind me? Would you like to know the name of that mountain peak? It's called Your Potential.
Far, we've been traveling far. Without a home, not without a star.
Oh my God.
Free.
Please stop the drinks at table two. Stop the drinks.
Hang on to a dream.
Yes. You're free to wear that, Ruth. Yes. Please return it after the show. Would you like the wig? It's probably a little warm at this point, Doctor. Oh, my God. Folks, I couldn't pay for this level of participation.
In the eye of the storm. In the eye of the storm.
Or how many of us love to be in a movie theater with a big screen, we've got our popcorn, and we're watching Indiana Jones as he jumps into a pit with 10,000 pythons and cobras, only to escape and find himself facing 10,000 bandits out on the desert. If we think about it, challenges or obstacles are always part of that story. It's never limited to something that just gives it a little flavor, but it really is an essential part of the story. Without it, there really would not be much of a story. So somehow we love going and watching or reading these stories, but when things like that happen in our own life, it just doesn't seem as fun or exciting, does it? Yet we really face those same moments that the adventurer does, or the explorer, or the hero does. In that moment, we decide, am I gonna give up, or am I gonna rise up? Am I gonna lament what was, how it was a year ago, or am I gonna forge ahead and create a new future, a new and better future?
They come to America. They come to America.
Story of two salesmen who worked for a shoe manufacturer. Now, this took place around the turn of the century, in the early 1900s. So the shoe manufacturer said, you know, there's this huge continent over here, Africa, and it's completely untapped. Is there any type of market here? So they sent out two different salesmen, and they fanned out. Each of them went their own way and went all around Africa. So back then, you know, transportation was slow, and it took them a while to get around the continent. And a few weeks later, the first salesman telegrammed back. And he said, situation hopeless. They don't wear shoes. A couple days later, the other salesman telegrammed back, glorious opportunity. They don't yet wear shoes. So as you approach, whether it's life or the economy, etc., are you the first salesman? Situation hopeless. Or are you glorious opportunity?
We've been traveling far.
Muhammad Ali, he embodied being the champion. Now, this wasn't limited to some nice little affirmations that he wrote out on his mirror and put it up with little flowers and said, I'm a good fighter. I punch hard. I look good in a big belt. No, I mean, he, in his mind, in his being, he was the champion. He thought like it, he spoke like it, he acted like it, he rhymed like it, he danced like it, he trained like it. In his reality, he was already the champion. He didn't wait for the belt to be the champion. He didn't wait for the belt to be the champion. He embodied the champion. And just like you with this campaign, your opportunity is not to wait for however many weeks down the road when the campaign concludes to say, well, we'll see. But it's to embody that success now. Embody that you are the leader, the organizer, the catalyst for an amazingly successful campaign.
Freedom's light burning warm. Freedom's light burning warm.